Here's a segment from a recent Gun Talk Radio episode. You can listen to all the Gun Talk Radio podcast however you tune in, or check out guntalk.com for more. Happy Mother's Day. I'm Tom Gresham. It is Gun Talk. We're talking about, well, guns and shooting and competition and what's it like to grow up around guns. I know that makes some people nervous. For me, it was just normal. I grew up with guns everywhere, as do a lot of people. And we've already talked with people who, you know, have kind of grown up, they brought their kids up as competitive shooters. It's a very cool thing. It's very interesting. And we're looking for your comments, your questions, even your stories about growing up with guns, particularly as it relates to moms who shoot. My mom sure shot. More of a hunter. She did a little bit of trap shooting, but not really a competitive shooter, but did love to hunt. So that was always fun. And it worked out great because she was only 5 feet tall. And so when I was a kid, I could use her shotguns that she'd cut off to a 12-inch length of pull. Bonus. When you talk about moms and people who shoot and people who, you know, teach youngsters to shoot, our next guest is right up here at the top. Julie Golub joins us from Team Smith & Wesson. Hi, Julie. How are you?
I'm very good. How are you, Tom?
I am excellent. It's a great... Well, by the way, first of all, happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. You know, I was talking about growing up around guns. Obviously, you know, yours is a house that has guns in it, I would think. But yeah. You've also, you know, you talk about and write about having guns around the house with kids and also how to get youngsters started in the shooting sports. Do you have any, like, some thoughts, some ideas, some tips you could share?
Absolutely. I grew up around the shooting sports competing with my dad, and I started out because I just liked hanging out with him, and he really made it a fun experience. So my advice to parents who are interested in getting their kids started is to make sure, one, that you're telling them that this is something that you do, obviously, mm-hmm. and two, bring them into the fold. Take them to a match. Now, I'm not saying go and spend a 12-hour day at the range.
Right.
Make it a nice, short day. Maybe go out to lunch or breakfast and make it something fun and enjoyable with nice weather, and so that they're going to be interested in coming back and giving it a try. The other piece of advice I have is obviously be very, very patient and make it about being fun, because that's really what the priority is.
I was just going to say that is the thing with kids, whether you're starting them off with shooting or fishing or whatever, short sessions and make sure that it's fun in whatever way you have to. If you're starting them off just shooting, make sure they're starting out close enough. Make sure it's easy. Make sure they have success doing it. Maybe even having fun targets like balloons or something. I don't know.
Exactly. I mean, you're talking about plinking. I mean, so many Americans grew up plinking. We don't have as many plinking opportunities as we used to, let's be honest.
No. Right.
But we have a lot of great shooting sports out there, sports like Rimfire Challenge and Steel Challenge, where the targets make noise and they're reactive and they're not really difficult. They're more about speed and wherever you hit on the steel makes it ring. And it's that kind of fun that makes kids want to come back for more. And parents, too.
What does it do? Just in your, you grew up shooting. You now have kids. You've worked with a lot of young shooters. What can it give a youngster to grow up, particularly shooting competition, but just being around guns and being accepted as a responsible person, I guess?
You know, I've always said that the shooting sports have taught me some really valuable life skills. First and foremost, the ability to safely handle a firearm, be confident with it, shoot it if I need to, kind of thing. But the shooting sports also teach kids about leadership, about organization, and about a sense of community. Because when you're on the range together, you're all a part of a big team, making sure that everybody stays safe. After that, you're all setting personal goals and trying to achieve them. And there's this sense of family that goes around with it that you don't get with a lot of other experiences with kiddos. So for me, it's the reason I fell in love with the shooting sports was the sense of that family, community. But also having those rules and guidelines built in, it teaches kids a lot about life.
It's funny. You didn't hear the first hour, unless you're cheating, because We had Michelle Serino on, and she was saying the same things about community and going to the Bianchi Cup with her son and, you know, watching if somebody, a kid, forgets something at a stage, other people run around making sure he gets it and gets it over to him, and just people taking care of each other. And she used that same term, community.
Yeah, it really is about that. And seeing the number of kids out there who are treated as equals. And that's one of the reasons I loved shooting as a teenager. Everywhere I went, everyone wanted to treat me like I was an angry teenager or a kid, or I wasn't, you know, a grown up enough. But on the range, everybody's the same. Everybody has to follow the rules. Everybody has to do what they're supposed to do. Now, granted, you may get a little bit more help if you're younger. But at the same time, I felt like I was going to be respected. And as a teenager, especially, that was huge. And, you know, I think it's one of the reasons I didn't go rebellious and do all the things a lot of my friends were doing.
No, I think that's exactly right. I remember being at the Grand American Trap Shoot when they were having the Scholastic Clay shooters in there. They had more than 1,000 youngsters. And I'm talking about, yes, some teenagers, but some were as young as 9 shooting trap. And every one of them was safe, and more than that, was respectful and careful. Now, certainly they're kids, but when it comes to gun handling, there was absolutely no issue with that.
Right. Well, you know, you establish those rules, and kids learn very quickly that if it's not acceptable and they're not going to be allowed to do something on the range, they can't come back. And so there's no wishy-washiness. There's no, well, maybe I can bend the rules a little bit. It just doesn't work that way.
No.
But it's a very good thing.
It is. All right, let me switch on you, because I just was spending some time at the range a couple of days ago. I went a little crazy. Found a used Smith Model 624 in-frame 3-inch barrel 44 special. I'm about 25 years old. And it's just one of those things of, you know, and so you'll love this. So I'm shooting that, and I'm shooting 1911s. So I just went completely old school. What is it about that combination of a really well-made revolver and a nice 1911 that we love so much?
You know, it's the feel, it's the heft, it's the craftsmanship that goes with it. It's the same reason we appreciate, you know, antique cars and older tools. There's just something about being able to hold something that was handcrafted in a way that's a little bit different than today. Not that today's bad, but there's just something about that style, that design, that life that is very alluring to so many people. I love it too.
we just had a guy call in and says, yeah, he went out to the range and he was shooting a Glock, you know, which Glocks are fine. They do what they do.
Absolutely.
And shot for a couple of hours. And then the guy said, well, you know, I've got these others. And he put an STI in his hands. And I said, well, wait. First of all, it costs 5 times as much as the Glock. And secondly, it's a 1911. So, yes, no wonder you shot it so well. But there's and what I'm thinking about from your perspective, 1911s, when you get them upgraded, you get like a performance center, 1911. It's just, if you haven't shot one of those, it's just a real thing, isn't it?
It is. It's the difference between, you know, a mass produced on the line, you know, you can piece any part together kind of handgun to one that has been completely fit together. And there's something about it. You know, even if it's inherently the same level of accuracy, you know, barrel to barrel or what have you. There's just something about being able to shoot a heavier gun with that kind of fit and the finishing touches, the sweeter trigger, that sort of thing, that just, it really makes a difference. Even if it's just mental, even if it's placebo.
Well, you know, and that's okay, because, I mean, what do we say, like 80 to 90% of this whole thing is between your ears anyway.
Exactly.
So, you know, if you, when you pick the gun up, if you think, I love this gun, I know I can shoot this gun, you will shoot that gun better.
Absolutely. It's so funny, you know, when people have multiple firearms, like I have a backup gun that I take with me to matches, no matter what the sport is, but my primary is my favorite, right? It doesn't matter if the backup gun shoots better. There's something about it.
Right.
You know, I'm like, no, that's mine.
This is the one. No, this is my gun. If I have to, I'll shoot the other, but this is the one I really like. You know,
right,
yes,
right.
It's weird what we do, but you know, we are so blessed with all these really the guns now, and you've been shooting for a long time. The guns we have today are simply better than they were 20 years ago.
They really are. It's really impressive, and the innovation is constantly happening. It's not like we're resting on our laurels anymore in the industry. It's constant thinking and how we can make something better. It's really neat.
Yep, it really is. Well, thank you for sharing your thoughts on getting youngsters into shooting. If you had like one takeaway to pass along to parents, particularly moms who might be nervous, worried, you know, some junior comes in and says, hey, I want to start shooting, what would you tell them?
I would say do it with them. You know, get out there, enjoy the sports together. This is going to be a relationship building experience that will last a lifetime. It may be scary at first, but just do it.
Very good. Julie Golub, thank you so much. Team Smith & Wesson, have a great Mother's Day.
Thank you so much.
All righty. Well, we'll see you soon somewhere. I hope we can all get together somewhere. Boy.
Yeah.
We're ready.
Yes.
Take care. Very good. Julie Golub, yeah, check it out. She's, man, talk about your shooter. By the way, it's juliegolub.com if you want to take a look at what she does. And her blog is terrific. And it's JulieGolub, juliegolub.com. All right, open lines for you, 866-TALK-GUN. Be right back.